Senator from Indiana.
So I had prepared remarks to address what many of my colleagues have just covered, and that would be the preposterous proposal of the Green New Deal. I want to take a little different angle. I think there is a point. So often, those of us on the conservative side of the ledger, I think, get overwhelmed by the conversation being dominated by the other side. And it's a fertile ground to want to try to use a better environment to parlay that in an incremental way into more government. I think what we've got here is just like addressing health care costs. We had Obamacare, the Affordable Care Act, which turned out to be the Unaffordable Care Act. But there were issues that were valid. In my own company, years ago, I was worried about it. Drafted a plan that was proactive, addressed high health care costs, made the pledge you should never go broke because you get sick or have a bad accident, crafted a plan through the real world that cut costs, and my employees have not paid a premium increase in 9 years. I want to take the Green New Deal. I'm a conservationist. I'm a member of the Nature Conservancy as a business and an individual. We cannot let the other side co-opt the issue, preempt it, because they think the argument is on their side. I'm not going to belabor the point that I think it's preposterous. I want to make the point that if you think any of that can be done, whether it's $50 trillion, $93 trillion, keep in mind we're running nearly trillion-dollar deficits. We're $22 trillion in debt. Does that sound like anything that the federal government could actually solve in a sustainable way when we're in a pickle like we're currently in? Until we change the dynamic here and get individuals that I think know how to do things where it works in states like Indiana, in many states, maybe let states have a bigger hand in the equation where their budgets are balanced, where they have cash balances, where it's not a false hope. Let's look at the particulars of what the Green New Deal is supposed to do in addition to cleaning up our environment, which we've made great strides with. It's being spun as an economic argument. It's the exact opposite of that. I want to challenge folks on our side of the ledger, from the practical side, to where we generally lose out on the general argument and incrementally things change against us over time. We just had legislation passed in 2017. I want to tell this little story, what we did in our own special way. I'm going to challenge enterprisers. I'm going to challenge businesses across the country to think about this as a way to avoid that. 2017, we had, in my opinion, for enterprisers, small businesses, farmers, I've been involved in both, the biggest opportunity that's come along in years. We are keeping more of our own resources, not sending it here to a broken institution that's given us all these deficits and debt. But we got to do something with it. Back in January of 2018, my son, who is one of my three kids now in my business, said, "Dad, let's take tax reform. Let's share the benefits with employees." Great idea. I didn't think it would have a bigger political meaning until he said, "Hey, let's put it in the company memo that it's due to tax reform." We've taken, in my mind, the biggest thing, whether you'd want to return the dividends into the environment, into higher wages, into whatever you want to do, and we've had less than a year to run with it. All I know is that many companies in Indiana, ours, we lowered health care costs, that flattened them for 9 years. We raised 401k benefits. We started quarterly bonuses instead of just annual ones. And we're doing what I think this country needs to do, quit looking to the federal government to solve all of our problems, even when they've got an argument like we need to further improve our environment. We need to avoid possibly a catastrophe down the road where we do stick our head in the sand. But don't look to this institution to do it, because I don't think you can credibly say that you can do anything in the context of the product that's been delivered over the last decade or two. States, individuals, businesses, organizations, but especially businesses, because we've reaped the benefits, in my opinion, of the biggest legislation that's occurred in decades. Put our money where our mouth is, where my company's is. Invest in your employees. Change a system from the bottom up, not from the top down.
Mr. President.